Allies turned foes. BJP and Shiv Sena have set off endless speculation as they've showered each other with praises after Devendra Fadnavis made a statement about how Sena and BJP are not enemies. Shiv Sena has responded. Sanjay Raut says that BJP and Sena are not India-Pakistan. They're not enemies. Interestingly, there's a very strange analogy that Raut has come up with, comparing BJP and Sena's relationship to separated couple Kiran Rao and Amir Khan, saying they're still friends like Amir and Kiran, but only have political differences. Raut's comments have triggered a lot of talk on whether the BJP and Sena are hinting at an alliance again, but the Shiv Sena has denied it, and so has the BJP. Both parties have made it clear that their political ideologies do not align currently.
मतभेद जरूर है, और मैंने भी तो बहुत दिनों से आपके साथ ये बोल रहा हूँ ना कि हम क्या भारत पाकिस्तान है, हिंदुस्तान पाकिस्तान नहीं है ना ये. आप देखो, आमिर खान और किरण राव रास्ते अलग हो गए लेकिन दोस्त है. बोला ना, वैसे है ये, रास्ते अलग है लेकिन दोस्ती कायम, दोस्ती रहेगी राजनीति में. उसका मतलब ये नहीं कि हम सरकार बनाने जा रहे हैं.
हम ये मानते हैं कि महाराष्ट्र में राजनीति में कटुता या शत्रुता नहीं रहनी चाहिए, इसमें हम विश्वास नहीं रखते. लेकिन हाथ मिला लेने से, जवानी जमा खर्च कर देने से बिगड़े हुए रिश्ते सुधरेंगे, अगर किसी को लगता है तो अच्छी बात है.
तो बिल्कुल है, महाराष्ट्र के राजकारण की यही मानसिकता है कि हम लोगों का कोई आपस में बैर नहीं होता, ये चुनाव की प्रक्रिया होती है. देवेंद्र फडणवीस ने जो स्टेटमेंट दिया उसमें कोई नयापन नहीं है.
These developments comes days after Shiv Sena MLA Pratap Sarnaik pushed for an alliance with BJP and even sent a letter to Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray. Take a look at what was said at that point of time.
राज्याच्या संघर्षामध्ये काही लोकप्रतिनिधींचा जो बळी जातो आहे त्यामध्ये एक प्रताप सरनाईक आहे, आणि त्यामुळे ईडीचा ससेमिरा मागे आहे, न्यायालयीन प्रक्रिया त्याच्यामध्ये चालू आहे. त्यामुळे जास्त कुठलाही सोशल मीडिया किंवा मीडियाच्या माध्यमातून समोर न जाता आपल्या माध्यमातून जेवढे जास्तीत जास्त लोकांसाठी काम करता येईल तेवढा प्रयत्न माझा आहे आणि त्याची.
A fresh split in Karnataka Congress has surfaced after Karnataka Congress Chief D.K. Shivakumar defied the statement of former Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiah about closing doors on the Congress defectors and said that rebels who left the party can rejoin and consider applications. Replying to the statement by D.K. Shivakumar, Siddaramaiah said that he's going to be speaking to D.K. Shivakumar and is still maintaining the stance that rebels will not be taken back at any cost. Then fighting within the party in other states as well. Rajasthan Congress in charge Ajay Makan is going to be in Jaipur tomorrow to meet the MLAs of both Gehlot and Pilot Camp. A dozen MLAs who are former Chief Minister Huda loyalists are going to be meeting General Secretary K.C. Venugopal to demand organizational changes in the state unit. The friction between Punjab Chief Minister Amarinder Singh and Navjot Singh Sidhu also continues. Let's bring you a few details about the implosion in Karnataka. Siddaramaiah versus D.K. Shivakumar over the rebel MLAs. This is how it's going on in Karnataka. There's been a war of words over the reinduction of the rebels between Siddaramaiah and D.K. Shivakumar. In fact, as far as Rajasthan is concerned, MLAs of Gehlot and Pilot camps are at loggerheads. That's Ashok Gehlot right there, Sachin Pilot right here. And in Rajasthan, the Congress in charge, Ajay Makan, is going to be reaching Jaipur on Tuesday. Let's get to Punjab now. Captain Amrinder Singh versus Navjot Singh Sidhu. There's a friction between Captain Amrinder Singh and Navjot Singh Sidhu over various issues. And in Haryana, Huda camp MLAs have demanded organizational change as well. Dozen Huda loyalist MLAs to meet the General Secretary K.C. Venugopal. So this is a Congress multi-state implosion which is going on at the moment. Late President Pranab Mukherjee's son, Abhijit Mukherjee, who is a former Congress MP from West Bengal, is all set to join the Trinamool Congress. Abhijit has been in talks with TMC leadership for the past few weeks. He met Abhishek Banerjee in Kolkata last month. Sources reveal finally a decision has been taken and Mukherjee is likely to be inducted in the party later today. Recently, Abhijit Mukherjee was seen voicing support for Mamata Banerjee on Twitter during the fake vaccination row in Kolkata. Meanwhile, Abhijit Mukherjee's sister, Sharmishta Mukherjee, continues to remain a Congress leader based in Delhi. No end to the all-out political war with the Rafael jet deal. Crucially, BSP chief Mayawati took a real jibe at the Congress itself over the defense deal while speaking on Rafael. Months before an all-important Uttar Pradesh polls, Mayawati referred to the big defense scam during the Congress regime. She intensified her attack on the Congress party, said that the allegations of commission and defense deal are not new here, but it is an old burning chapter when the Congress government was in power. She said it is better that the present government at the center puts an end to this issue by settling the Rafael dispute according to public satisfaction that is justified. A French judge has been appointed to lead the highly sensitive judicial probe into the 59,000 crore rupees Rafael fighter jet deal with India. French investigative website Mediapart has reported this story as well. Congress has demanded a joint parliamentary committee or a JPC probe into this matter. The Rafael dogfight continues between Congress MP Rahul Gandhi and BJP a day after France's National Financial Prosecutor's Office ordered a judicial probe over alleged corruption charges in Rafael deal. Rahul Gandhi has hit out at Prime Minister Modi through his Instagram post. Here is the full story.
The ghost of Rafael deal back to haunt Modi government. After a French court orders judicial probe over the charges of corruption and favoritism in the 59,000 crore rupees deal between France and India. Major showdown has erupted back home between Congress and the BJP. Rahul Gandhi, who spearheaded his party's campaign over alleged corruption in the Rafale deal in the run-up to the 2019 polls, has once again launched a fresh attack on Prime Minister. Rahul has put out an image on his Instagram handle mocking the Prime Minister. He also put out a caption, "Chor ki dadhi," meaning thief's beard.
देश को रुचि है कि 570 करोड़ की चीज 1670 में क्यों खरीदी गई? 126 विमान आने थे सिर्फ 36 क्यों खरीदे गए? इस तरह के जो बातें करते हैं कि दाढ़ी की फोटो क्यों डाल दी? यह और स्पष्ट बता देता है कि वाकई तिनका है, एक नहीं अनेक तिनके हैं.
BJP is furious and calls Rahul's attack a new low. BJP challenged Rahul to fight 2024 elections on Rafale issue.
Again, the Congress is trying to demand JPC probe and raking up the issue. It's nothing but raking up, flogging a dead horse. It shows that they have no issues to fight with Narendra Modi's government.
Rafale is probably one of the few weapons in Congress' hand to take on the Modi government over corruption issue. The campaign backfired in 2019 after Supreme Court gave a clean chit that helped BJP to return to power for the second time with greater majority.
The investigation launched by French authorities in the Rafale deal has brought storm in India. India's main opposition party, Congress, and several others are now demanding the joint parliamentary committee probe in the deal. While the BJP rubbishing the charges, challenging the Congress to battle the next general elections on this issue, Congress continue to escalate attack on the government. With this report in New Delhi with Sanjay Kumar, I'm Ashutosh Mishra for India Today.
Politics are wraps over RSS chief Mohan Bhagwat's remark on Hindutva day after RSS chief said that those who indulge in lynchings are against Hindutva. AIMIM chief Asaduddin Oasi has now lashed out at Bhagwat over his comment. In his tweet, Oasi contended that lynching is a product of Hindutva. He further said that these criminals behind lynching are the backbone of the government as the government continues to shield such lynching accused. Oasi also said that violence, murder and cowardice all are part of Godse's Hindutva ideology. In an event in Ghaziabad yesterday, Bhagwat made a unity pitch. He said that if a Hindu says no Muslim should live here, then a person is not Hindu. Bhagwat further added that people behind lynching in name of cow are against Hindutva, as law should take its own course.
अगर हिंदू कहते कि यहाँ एक भी मुसलमान नहीं रहना चाहिए, तो हिंदू हिंदू नहीं रहेगा। नहीं, विचार मेरा नहीं है। ये विचार संघ की विचारधारा का अंग है, क्योंकि हिंदुस्तान एक राष्ट्र है। हम कहते हैं कि हिंदुस्तान हिंदू राष्ट्र है, गौ माता पूज्य है, लेकिन लिंचिंग करने वाले ये हिंदुत्व के खिलाफ जा रहे हैं, वो आतताई है। कानून के जरिए उनका निपटारा होना चाहिए, क्योंकि ऐसे केसेस बनाए भी जाते हैं तो बोल नहीं सकते आजकल कहां सही है कहां गलत है, लेकिन कानून को अपना काम करना चाहिए, तहकीकात करनी चाहिए ठीक से, बिना पार्शियलिटी किए सबका न्याय करना चाहिए और दोषी को सजा होनी चाहिए।
इस तरह के गुमराही गैंग के जो दुष्प्रचार थे, वो संघ के विचारों को किस तरह से नुकसान पहुंचाओ, इस षड्यंत्र और साजिश में लगे रहे हैं। और सार्वजनिक कार्यक्रमों के जरिए ये तमाम जो गुमराही गैंग था, इन गुमराही गैंग ने जो कुछ भी षड्यंत्र साजिश पाप और लोगों के दिलो दिमाग में जहर भरने का खतरनाक काम किया था, वो एक्सपोज हो रहा है। उनकी जो हताशा निराशा है वो इस बात का प्रतीक है कि इनकी जो पूरी की पूरी इस गुमराही गैंग की जो साजिशें षड्यंत्र हैं वो सामने आ रही हैं।
भारत हिंदू, ये पर्यायवाची शब्द हैं, इनसे किसी को डरने की जरूरत नहीं है। वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स से ऊपर उठकर और सबको साथ लेकर चलना और सबने साथ मिलकर चलना, यह देश की सदा जरूरत रही है।
आई बिलीव दैट द फेसेट ऑफ इस्लाम दैट सपोर्ट्स ब्रदरहुड एंड पीस विल राइज फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड विल प्रमोट द ब्रदरहुड एंड यूनिटी ऑफ द टू कम्युनिटीज।
आरएसएस प्रमुख श्री मोहन भागवत द्वारा कल गाजियाबाद में आयोजित एक कार्यक्रम में भारत में सभी धर्मों के लोगों का डीएनए एक होने व भीड़ हिंसा हिंदुत्व के खिलाफ आदि होने की जो बात कही गई है वह किसी के भी गले के नीचे से आसानी से नहीं उतरने वाली है, क्योंकि आरएसएस वह बीजेपी एंड कंपनी के लोगों की तथा इनकी सरकारों की भी कथनी व करनी में अंतर सभी देख रहे हैं।
मोहन भागवत जी एक व्यक्ति नहीं है, एक संघ के प्रमुख हैं, और एक संघ के प्रमुख होने के नाते जो बड़ी जिम्मेदारी से उन्होंने ये बात कही है, मैं समझता हूँ कि ये सबके लिए एक बड़ा संदेश है। तो मुझे लगता है कि चाहे कोई भी हो, कानून के खिलाफ वर्जी किसी तरह से भी कोई अपराध करता है वो अपराधी है, वो किसी भी समाज का हो सकता है, लेकिन अपराधी अपराधी होता है, अपराध करने वाले को सजा मिलनी चाहिए।
Former Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh will not appear before the Enforcement Directorate today in connection with the money laundering case. In reply to the Enforcement Directorate, Anil Deshmukh has expressed shock over the depiction of events that had occurred from 25th of June onwards. He has said that he is suffering from various comorbidities, including hypertension, and hence will not be able to meet them in person. Deshmukh has also claimed that he has sought the details of the charges against him from agencies but did not receive any response or details as yet. Anil Deshmukh has also requested the agency to wait for the outcome of his petition in the Supreme Court. He's filed a petition in court seeking protection from any coercive action by the central agency. However, according to sources, ED will oppose this plea in the court. Sources say the ED's ground to oppose the plea would be based on the fact that the former Maharashtra Home Minister was given ample amount of time to join the probe, and after multiple summons, he did not help the probe agency. A massive political row has erupted over an RTI revelation into Maharashtra government's whopping 155 crore rupees expenditure on publicity campaigns. The BJP is all set to corner the Aghari government in the assembly session over 155 crore rupees being spent on advertisement between December 2019 and 2021. The Directorate General of Information and Public Relations has informed an RTI activist that the Thackeray government has spent over 9 crore rupees every month on publicity campaigns. BJP leader Devendra Fadnavis slammed the Thackeray government and demanded a proper investigation into this matter.
पैसे नहीं हैं, पैसे नहीं हैं। चिल्लाने वाली महाराष्ट्र की सरकार 155 करोड़ रुपए पब्लिसिटी पर खर्च करती है। पब्लिसिटी किस बात की? खुद की वाह वाह करने की। खुद की पब्लिसिटी करने की बजाय या यदि पैसे वे अच्छे काम में लगाते, लोगों के हितों में लगाते तो ठीक होता।
Let's cut straight across to Lalu Prasad Yadav, listening to what he says. Prasad Yadav is addressing the 25th Foundation Day. This is the RJD Foundation Day, 25th Foundation Day that we're talking about. Lalu Prasad is speaking live, listening live to what he has to say. This in just about a bit, but there's some issue with the live feed that we're getting at the moment. But RJD's 25th Foundation Day is the focus at the moment, as Lalu Prasad Yadav is addressing, making an address on the 25th Foundation Day of the RJD. I think we're being able to listen to him.
वो सब चुनाव में ज्यादा से ज्यादा MLA हमारे पार्टी को और लोकसभा में भी हमें काफी सीट मिला हमारे पार्टी को और लोकसभा में भी हमें काफी सीट मिला आज भी हमारी पार्टी भले पीछे करने का काम किया हमारा प्रेजेंस है लोकसभा में हमारे लोग हैं राज्यसभा में लोग हैं मैं धन्यवाद देता हूं आप सबको कि जब जब तीनों चुनाव आया ये लोकसभा का इधर और भी जो चुनाव था असेंबली का हम तड़पते रह गए हम बाहर नहीं आए हमको इस बात का मलाल है और तेजस्वी प्रसाद यादव नेता विरोधी दल इनसे बात होते रहते थे लेकिन तेजस्वी ने कहा पापा चिंता मत करिए आप घबराइए नहीं हम इन लोगों से रिपोर्ट लेंगे और जो हाल हुआ आप जानते हैं
करते हैं सबसे आगे बढ़ चढ़ के हम लोगों ने साथ दिया है अरवानी जी का गिरफ्तारी मामूली बात नहीं था अरवानी जी का गिरफ्तारी से हमारी सरकार का तो प्यार में नहीं हुआ लेकिन स्वर्गीय बीपी सिंह की सरकार हमारे से यहाँ पूरा विड्रॉ कर दिया
Slipping to a break when we return. Coming up next, Congress protests outside Delhi Chief Minister's residence against the hike in fuel prices. More details in just about a bit. Delhi Congress has staged a protest outside Chief Minister Kejriwal's residence in the national capital. Protesters gathered outside to demonstrate hike in the fuel prices, with the petrol prices almost touching 100 rupees per litre mark in Delhi. Hundreds of protesters were a part of the agitation.
Congress workers are protesting at the residence of Arvind Kejriwal, demanding reduction in rates for petrol and diesel. There are several protesters in unit protest. आप यूनिट प्रोटेस्ट करके क्या दिखा
रहे हो यूनिट प्रोटेस्ट नहीं है ये केजरीवाल की नाकामियां है केजरीवाल की नाकामियां केजरीवाल जब दिल्ली की जनता एक्सीडेंट से मर रही थी आज आप महंगाई बढ़ाकर क्या दिल्ली की जनता को दिखाने जाते हैं इसमें दिखाने के लिए हमारे गलत है अपनी नीतियां बदलो रोको राहत दो
वन हैंड देयर इज अ ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर इन देयर हैंड ऑन द अदर हैंड देयर इज अ एलपीजी सिलेंडर शोइंग दैट द रेट्स हैव बीन इंक्रीज नाउ Even senior leaders, Congress leaders, are here present, including the Delhi Congress chief, Anil Chaudhary, and Susmita Singh Dev, who is women Congress president. So, right now, the protest is going on at the residence of Arvind Kejriwal, who is Delhi's chief minister, and the Congress workers are demanding
reduction in VAT rates. At least they want that some relief must be given to the common people in view of increased prices. The petrol prices have almost touched rupee 100 per liter, and that's why they are demanding relief for the common man. With camera person Premchand Mishra, it's Kumar Kunal for India Today from Delhi.
In the midst of fuel price hike across the nation, TMC and BJP have engaged in a war of words on Twitter. TMC MP from Diamond Harbour, Abhishek Banerjee, has attacked the BJP and said his fuel prices hit a historic high. The BJP government seems to be working very hard towards adding the boost to the public. He further added that not much has changed since June 2020. The same old blame game continues while the demands of the people of India are conveniently ignored. BJP quoted Abhishek's tweet and reacted that 42% of all the taxes have been collected go to the state government. Why hasn't Mamata Banerjee reduced the state levy, which is the highest amongst all the states? BJP has further attacked the TMC to fund its syndicates, the need to fund its syndicates. Petrol prices in Kolkata are set to reach 100 rupees per litre mark in the coming days. The current price of petrol in Kolkata is 99.88 per litre, while diesel prices at 92.31 per litre. Prices in other districts of Bengal, such as Berhampur, Purulia, Ghagram, Krishnagar, have already crossed the 100 litre mark.
लोगों को तो बहुत दिक्कत हो रहा है लोगों ने अपने गाड़ी जहां 500 फ्यूल करने के जगह में वहां 300 कर रहे हैं इतना परेशानी हो रहा है और अभी लॉकडाउन का समय है उन लोगों को और परेशानी हो रहा है कोरोना वायरस का समय है अभी गाड़ी नहीं चल रहा है ऊपर से दाम इतना ज़्यादा बढ़ गया है इतना ज़्यादा दिक्कत हो रहा है कि हम लोग क्या बताएं
इतना महंगाई है मोदी की सरकार में कि सभी लोग परेशान हैं ये पेट्रोल का एकदम महंगाई इतना बढ़ गया है कि इंसान को एकदम सर चढ़ कर बोल रहे हैं बहुत परेशान है इतना महंगा है जिसका कोई हिसाब नहीं इतना नहीं होना चाहिए लेकिन सरकार को इसके बारे में कुछ सोचना चाहिए ये पेट्रोल इतना आदमी इतना महंगा भराएगा तो जो मिडिल क्लास के जो लोग हैं जो रोज़ कमाते खाते हैं वो लोग कैसे घर चलाएंगे
The price of petrol is soon to touch the rupees 100 per litre mark as we can see right here. The price of petrol currently is 99.88 per litre and the diesel is at 92.31 per litre here in Kolkata. However, in certain districts like Krishnanagar and other districts in North Bengal and even in South Bengal, the price of petrol has already reached 100 rupees per litre. Now, as far as Kolkata is concerned, it will impact the people more because of the number of people here commuting from one place to another, though many are working from home. For those who have to go to their workplaces and with fewer public transport on the road, it will be a big problem. Now, a war of words has broken out between the BJP and the Trinamool Congress. Well, the BJP had tweeted out on Sunday speaking about this issue, but it was in response to what the Trinamool Congress had said. Abhishek Banerjee had said on Sunday that the people's woes should be looked at because the Narendra Modi government is adding to the people's woes with the rise in the fuel prices, and the BJP had hit back questioning the state government because here 42% of the taxes go to the state coffers, and what is being done as far as this levy is concerned and why that has not been reduced in the state, which is one of the highest. So a war of words breaking out here between the BJP and the TMC, even as it is the common man here in Kolkata wondering what needs to be done. With camera person Shyam Sundar Ghosh, Prema Rajaram in Kolkata for India Today.
Alcohol lovers in Coimbatore were unable to control their joy as liquor shops opened in the region after nearly 2 months. People were seen rejoicing, celebrating the moment by dancing and bursting crackers as well. We're leaving you with a story. (laughs)